Hi everyone, this is Aki with another Google Sheets video. We're going to go over how to select a random name from a list. Maybe you have a very long list of customers, employees, any other very long list of items or data, and you need to select random three items and how to do that. So I have a list here of employees, and you can see it's very long. Like if I click command arrow down, I can scroll down to the last row, which is 30,383. So this is a huge database of employees. If I click command arrow up, I can go to the very top, and that's for Mac. For PC, you have control and then the arrows that you can use. So you know if I try to do it myself, it would be very biased and very hard to do. So you want to make sure you put a function or formula that does that automatically for you and it's not biased. So I'm going to use the RANDBETWEEN function in Google Sheets. So I will start typing RANDBETWEEN. And if you want to know, you know, what you need for your formula, sometimes it shows up like this, or if it doesn't, then you have a question mark on a side that you can click and you can have more information about the formula. It tells you the syntax, what items do you need to specify. Oh, you see now you have this formula help question mark that shows up. So I'm going to say the first value is 1, the first item in my list, and the last one, now I checked that the row was 30,383, close parenthesis. Now, right now, okay, that's great. It gives me 27,391 item in a list, but it's really not providing any information. I still have to scroll to try to find it, and it's really not pulling anything else. And the database, I mean, and the formula, it's not dynamic because the row, let's say if the data has been updating and, you know, the records maybe will be changing over time, I want to make sure that the formula is being updated. So I want to make it more dynamic. So in this case, instead of the number, I'm going to actually ask and use the COUNTA formula and make the formula calculate, you know, how many rows there are. So I'm going to use A2, and I'm going to use an open reference, which is just reference to the column. So when you have open reference, they're saying the whole column. Now you want to be careful, make sure there's no other data below, but let's say this tab and this sheet I'm using purely for this information. So I'm going to also select this and make sure that this is absolute reference. So I'm going to change that, adding the dollar sign and close the parenthesis, close it and do that. And so now I can actually select and copy it for the three rows, for the three winners, the three selections that we talked about. And so now I still have a reference to a row, but it doesn't really pull the information. So now I'm actually going to add the formula text here so you can see the formula, how it keeps changing what we're doing. So right now it's just doing the random selection between one, count how many rows there are, and give me random selection. And every time now this RANDBETWEEN randomizer, it's an active and dynamic in a sense also, that every time you change something in your sheet, this will update. So let's say if I, you see anything that I'm doing, anything that's being changed, it's updating it. So be aware of it, that if you want to choose something random, like it will keep updating every time you change the sheet or save it and so on. So maybe you want to do copy values at that moment, or take a screenshot or something like that. So that's what we have, but we want to actually pull the value from these cells. I don't want to have to go to the 13,000 row to find it. So what you want to do is add to your formula, you want to add the index formula. And what's the index formula? Returns the content of a cell specified by location. So that's what we're doing. We specify the location of the row by adding the RANDBETWEEN formula. So now we just have to specify, we want to pull the data. So we do want to have to provide, we do need to provide the range. So a range is A2, and I'm going to keep an open reference and make this an absolute value as well, because we're going to be copying it down. And let's see if I need another parenthesis. Okay, no, it's worked fine. And then I copy it over. And now you can see that it randomized and pulled the actual names from my list. So I didn't have to go and find these names. And let's say, you know, you have this now. So you have the three names, and maybe in your database you have phone numbers or emails or a way to contact them. So you don't want to have to go, okay, I have the name, but now I have to go scrolling my list and find it. Maybe you want to right away be found. So you can use the VLOOKUP function here. So I want to just add the data that I want to copy over here. So we're going to pull that information. You might have the email and phone number and so on, but I just have here department and salary or not salary, full-time employee data. So what we want to do is say VLOOKUP, and now we want to do search key. So we want to reference our found random name, and I'm going to add absolute value to the column. And now I'm going to say, what's the range? The range is actually going to be these four columns, right? 1, 2, 3, 4. That's where we have the data, absolute value to the columns. And now which column? So this one is department, which is column 1, 2, 2 and false. This is not a sorted data. That's why I'm putting false. And okay, so this is great. However, if I want to just copy it over here, I have to still change the row, I mean the column now. This is a third column, and this is, and you see every time I'm updating it, the randomizer is changing new names. It's selecting new names. So now I have this. However, maybe you have even more data, and it's kind of, you know, manual process when you have to manually change the columns. Maybe you want to do an array formula that will update all of the columns at once. So what we have to do is go to our VLOOKUP, add the curly bracket, put column 2, then I know I also have to add column 3, column 4, close the curly bracket, and now it's still not an array formula. You have to click Shift Command Return on Mac, and now if I enter, oh, it's giving me an error. Why? Because it's saying it can't expand because you have data in column L. So I have to first delete this old data to let the array formula update, and then copy it over down. And now we have not only randomized number from the list, but also the pulls, the formula pulls the actual names, the records, and then it provides more information that's referencing these records. So this is the way to find, you know, and select a random name or an item from a very long list in Google Sheet. Thanks so much for watching.